There's a new update for Tasker. Sit tight, cause this one's loaded. You get sleep tracking. Easily get data from any text format. Parse, format, and do calculations with dates.
Turning on Tasker Lite.
And much more. Check it out.
Sleep tracking.
There's now a sleeping state in Tasker, which means that you can automate your phone based on if you're sleeping or not. For example, you could automatically turn on Do Not Disturb when you're sleeping. And turn it off when you're awake. Or you could track all of your sleep events to notifications or a Google Sheet so that you can learn what exactly your phone thinks about your sleeping patterns.
JSON, HTML, XML and CSV parsing.
Tasker can now directly read multiple structured text formats, so you can easily automate stuff based on the weather or Bitcoin prices, for example.
Quick, sell your Bitcoin. It is currently worth €45,361.51.
For example, JSON is a popular way to keep structured data in a piece of text. Many services around the web output data in this format. Previously, to get the weather data from this weather API, for example, you had to do very complicated parsing to get just the data you want. Now, you simply have to do this. By simply writing the variable name, dot, and then the field name, you can directly access the data you want, no extra actions needed.
Parse or format date and time.
It is now much easier to handle date and time related actions in Tasker. For example,
turning on Tasker Lite.
To turn on the lights automatically before sunset, you could get the sunset time from a web API, parse it, and directly subtract 30 minutes from it in a single action. Besides parsing any date, this action can also format dates and times in any format imaginable.
Today is Wednesday.
Simple match and regex.
In another move to make getting the data you want easier, there's this new action in Tasker that allows you to extract data from any random text and directly create variables with it. For example, you could easily parse incoming SMS like these to automatically set the numbers on your clipboard and paste them where needed. And if simple matching is not enough for your heart to parse text, you can always switch to regex mode to parse anything and everything.
More stuff.
You can now do more with arrays. With the new array merge action, you can take multiple related arrays and merge them all into one. So you can show a list of notifications complete with app name, title, and text, for example. You now also have a helper to help you with available array functions and a few new array functions to boot. Check out how easy it is to join all of the items of an array into a single string with the separator you want. The new tick event allows you to trigger tasks very frequently, even every 100 milliseconds if you want. Check out the speed this Tasker notification is updated at. Favorite actions allow you to very quickly access the actions you use the most by simply long-clicking the plus button when creating a task. You can even create shortcuts to actions that execute your favorite tasks directly. Check out the video description where you have links to import all of the examples in this video directly into your Tasker setup and can also access the full changelog for this version. All this and much more in the new Tasker.